The Citizenship Amendment Bill 2016 achieves number of important historical, legislative and constitutional purposes. As far as the history is concerned, the bill aims to mitigate the historical mistakes of those communities, the six communities which have been identified in those countries. As far as the constitution is concerned, the constitution makers left it to the parliament to enact the laws with regard to the citizenship. As such, we have 1955 and then five more amendments. In other words, the Citizenship Act and the citizenship criteria have been evolving in accordance with the needs, the exigencies, the historical circumstances, not only in India, but also abroad as well. So in this sense, this is a standard evolution, and as and when more such circumstances will arise, the parliamentarians will use the constitutional wisdom to devise the new criteria to fill in the gaps. As far as the arguments of arbitrariness or discrimination is concerned, the bill definitely sustains a no whatsoever arbitrary or discriminatory tent. In fact, the bill will withstand any scrutiny on these two important aspects. The bill is neither an animus towards any particular community or so. In fact, what does it? It selects. And one has to keep in mind, the bill is speaking only about the enabling provision. It doesn't grant the citizenship. What it does is, it gives certain flexibility. For example, it talks about reducing from 11 years to 6 years. For example, it tells that those particular communities who decided to stay back in India will not be considered for the purposes of the act illegal immigrants. It doesn't mean that they are going to get citizenship. They still have to follow the Citizenship Act, and all the regulations since then have passed. They have to go through the rigor of administrative machinery as well. Only what this bill does, it relaxes the criteria. And the main aim of this relaxing criteria is, as I said in the beginning, to remove the historical gaps or historical mistakes which these religious communities have been subjected to over the last 75 years. So in all sense of the term, the Citizenship Amendment Bill is one of the most positive moves as far as the Citizenship Act is concerned. It will definitely also withstand the scrutiny of international law in terms of UDHR and ICCPR, because by ensuring that it is a right to protect, the clause is on protection clause is actually protective cause. So protective clause is protective cause, and therefore India, by signing this into law, will ensure that this particular bill will make sure that all these communities will be able to apply for waiver in years to come, and at future point in time, this, as I say, historical grievance which has been taken will be taken care of.